Hello everyone, so how are you? This is class 9th polity and we will be dealing with election commission today. Okay, this is by me, I am Charu Modi. This is about me, I am a National Law University graduate, I have written mains. Please rate, review, recommend and share. Okay, starting with election commission. Election commission is a body which finds its constitution, its composition, its functions, everything in the constitution under article 324. We will be reading all these things in detail in higher classes. So it is article 324. The election commission is headed by chief election commissioner who is appointed by the president of India. Okay, so he is appointed, but he is not answerable to the president of India or the government of India in any manner. Fine. So he is not answerable to president or the government of India. Election Commission takes decisions on every aspect of conduct and control of elections, from announcement of election to declaration of results. So this is very peculiar that Election Commission has entire responsibility of the entire election, right since it is announced till the results are announced. Fine. And they implement the code of conduct and punish any candidate or party that violates it. So they are very peculiar about the entire conducting of elections, because they ensure that the elections are free and fair. Okay, during the election period, the Election Commission can order the government to follow some guidelines to prevent use and misuse of governmental power to enhance its chances to win elections or to transfer some government officials. You have to remember that there is always a chance the party which has formed the government is obviously powerful, because all the machinery is working with it. So there is always a chance that the government can misuse the powers and the same party comes into existence again, into government again. So the Election Commission makes sure that such misuse of power is not done by the party which is in the government. Right. And then such transfer of government officials is also maintained that it is not at disadvantage of the elections. Okay. On the election duty, the government officers work under the control of Election Commission and not the government. So you have to make sure that while the government officers, the teachers and whosoever are functioning under the Election Commission, for the election, they are functioning under the Election Commission and not the government, right? Now, challenges to free and fair elections. Okay, there are challenges like big and unfair advantage over smaller parties and independents, right? So there are parties which are big, they have larger money, they have bigger organization. So they have more chances of influencing people than the smaller candidates or smaller parties or independents. Okay, candidates with criminal connections. So there are few candidates who have criminal background or who have connection with people with criminal mentality and activities. So it is easier for them to influence people or threaten people. Okay, so that is a hurdle in free and fair elections. Some families tend to dominate political parties. So some families which have been in politics since always, they have a chance of influencing people. They dominate the political parties. Little choice to ordinary citizens. Okay, so there is not much choice which is available with the citizens, because there are very few candidates, and then almost all the candidates, all the parties have almost the same ideologies. Any party merges with any other party, they have coalition going on. Okay, so there is very less choice that the candidates are remaining with, that the citizens are having anymore. Smaller parties and independent candidates suffer a huge disadvantage compared to the bigger parties. So there are parties and there are independent candidates who are not in position to carry out that big rallies. They are not in position to hold such large public meetings. So it is at disadvantage of such smaller parties. Okay. So these are the few challenges which actually influence the people and is a hurdle in free and fair elections. Next, we come to few institutions that are important in policy decisions are Prime Minister and the Cabinet, are institutions that take all important policy decisions. And there are civil servants who are responsible for taking steps to implement the minister's decisions. So you will see that there are two institutions which are functioning simultaneously in coordination with each other. First is the prime minister, so you can call it the political executive, and or you can call it the temporary executive. And we have civil servants, which is usually called bureaucracy, or you call it permanent executive, because they do not change with time, whereas prime minister and cabinet changes every 5 years. So these are the institutions that are functioning for the proper policy decision making. Okay, so this was all about the election commission and the institution that are functioning for decision making. So please let me know if something is uncomprehendable, and please rate, review, recommend and share. Thank you so much.